this edition of Extra Butter. Trolls World Tour probably stopped by your house and broke box office records for home viewing. Justin Timberlake stops by to tell us why. Also, need to get away from it all during these times? Kristen Stewart tells us how you can do it underwater. That is, get away from it all. Underwater! And the Oscar race has begun online with Netflix's new original, Sergio. Its director, its star, stop by to tell us why. We've got that and more on this shelter-in-place edition of Extra Butter. Although they're all going to be shelter-in-place for a while. Hope you guys are doing awesome. You know, now more than ever, home entertainment means entertainment because that's the only place you're getting it. Unprecedented. Universal Pictures was set to release Trolls worldwide in theaters everywhere, but those theaters became your living rooms. And it crushed it. People gobbled this up over the weekend. Has the voices of Anna Kendrick, Justin Timberlake as Branch. But did you know this isn't his first foray into animation? No, it all began over a decade ago with Shrek 3. Now, he went on to do stuff like Yogi Bear, and he was the voice of Boo Boo as well. So he loves voicing animation. And though he's also the musical director in this, I caught up with him way back when at a time yonder to talk about that Shrek 3. Take a listen.
I loved making Shrek the Third, and it was probably the easiest thing I've ever done.
Easy why?
Easy because you show up to work in your pajamas, and you don't have to memorize lines.
You don't even have to bathe for this.
That's right. You work for about 4 hours at a time, six times. Done.
As we wrap this up, which member of the Shrek 3 cast, which character in Shrek 3 do you think is most likely to bring sexy back?
Definitely Puss in Boots. No question.
A younger, cleaner-cut version of Justin Timberlake before having kids wore him out. Actually, he says one of the greatest joys of all is doing movies that his kids can enjoy. We caught up with him on the set, and by that, I mean like 3 feet outside of the sound booth, to talk about this.
I think the reason people connect with Trolls is that there's a beautiful, humorous, loving way to bring you a message of diversity and how that should be celebrated. And at the same time, I mean, all this fantastic music. Tiny Diamond is my name. Come straight from my daddy's name. My body's
made of glitter. And I'll throw it in your face. Peace and love, Tiny and Daddy.
It's just a great ride every time. This movie is really funny and really musical and really has a wonderful, wonderful message for young people and for older people like myself.
And by the way, in case you're wondering, yes, the music soundtrack is available, but I don't think it's just the music that makes this movie so special, so spectacular right now. I think it has a lot to do with the fact that we're at home. But for more on that, I go to my good friend. You know him, you love him, you read his reviews in Rolling Stone magazine, LA Times, New York Times, and everywhere in between. It's Shawn Edwards, ladies and gentlemen.
What's up, man?
I miss you, man.
I know. We haven't seen each other for like an entire month. This is the longest I've ever sat still in my entire adult life.
Yeah, I know. This is crazy. So we're going to talk about Trolls World Tour in a second. But right now, I want to talk about some stuff behind the scenes. So Shawn and I both broadcast in our local markets and nationally talking about movies. We also produce movies. So with that said, what's the state of the affairs right now with your movie producing, Shawn?
It's shut down. Like, nothing's happening. There's no production going on whatsoever anywhere in the world. Everything's in limbo. We had a couple of releases scheduled for this year, and we really are completely uncertain. We have a movie called Fatale that was scheduled to open on June 19th. It still has that date, but it's going to be highly unlikely that it actually opens on June 19th. There's just a lot of unknown and uncertainty. And then we have another movie called Meet the Blacks 2, The House Next Door, which is supposed to open in October.
But Meet the Blacks 2, since that's based loosely, it's a comedy take on The Purge. Isn't that a great time to release that at home when everybody is locked down?
I would think so. I'm not in charge of that decision. I can only throw my opinion. I was lobbying for that movie to come out right now because people are starving for content, particularly that demo that movie would appeal to. I mean, look what Trolls World Tour did when it went straight to VOD. It broke all kinds of records. So people are starving for new content right now.
Yeah, nice segue into that. Normally, we were just weighing upon this movie, its merits as a movie altogether. But what do you think it had that spoke to audiences right now that needed to see it right now in the way they are?
It's new content. It's a feature film, number one. So the quality was there. It's a family film. The entire family can watch. You got millions of households that have kids that have been locked down for weeks. I mean, it was a perfect excuse to sit around the flat screen as a family and enjoy something new, enjoy something fresh, and more importantly, enjoy something that's really fun. Like, it's energetic, it's colorful, it's playful, it's loaded with music. I mean, it's just the perfect pandemic type of film. New content is king, man. I mean, just look at that documentary on Netflix, Tiger King. Under normal circumstances, it might have created a little buzz, but it became a pop culture phenomena because of the pandemic.
With that said, what old is new again? So before we let you go, what's a timeless classic people may have forgotten about that Shawn Edwards says you should dust off during this time of need?
I got a couple. I mean, right now, Molly's Game is available on Netflix. I love that movie. I think a lot of people missed it when it initially came out. It's a very strong movie. I just revisited The Social Network. I love that movie as well. And then Players Club with Ice Cube, man. I forgot how much of a classic that movie is, man. All three of those are on Netflix right now. I revisited all three of those just because.
That's a good trifecta, good trifecta. And if you think about it, though, Social Network has a cameo appearance by Justin Timberlake, which brings us back to Trolls.
That's right, man. I'm a Justin fan. I'm a JT fan. I can't wait till this is all over. First thing I'm going to go do is go check him out in concert. I don't care where he's at. If he's in Singapore, I'm going to fly to Singapore. If he's in Seattle, I'm going to fly to Seattle. If he's in London, I'm going to fly to London. First thing I'm doing when this is over is go see some JT live.
I'm cashing in some miles and joining you on that. Shawn Edwards, where do we catch up with you? Where do we find you online?
At home. Not just joking. S. Edwards KC everywhere, all social platforms, or fox4kc.com.
I miss having kind of a studio audience, but imagine, if you will, a big thunderous round of applause. Shawn Edwards, ladies and gentlemen. Shawn Edwards.
Miss live interaction, man. But I'm holding up, man. The mental state is strong, but I need some interactivity, man. Got to connect with the people real soon, hopefully. God bless. Hey, man, stay safe. Be healthy. Stay home.
Thank you very much, man. All right, when we come back, speaking of new to streaming and home video, it's Underwater, an epic underwater adventure about people underwater. Twilight's Kristen Stewart joins us next. Welcome back to Extra Butter, our shelter-in-place edition. I'm sheltering in place in my home here in Placer County, California. Hope you're doing well in your home and not sick of each other. Might I suggest a movie to break some of that family tension? A movie like Underwater, set underwater. The movie has a relatively small cast for reasons that I don't want to give away right now because I would be plot spoiling, but I caught up with Kristen Stewart from Twilight to talk about the dangers of shooting a movie underwater.
You know, people are going to ask you after this, what was the hardest part? Because it looks relentless, and clearly most of it's not green screen. You're doing this practically. You're in that suit.
Yeah. Yeah, really common question, like in interviews about movies, is always like, hey, what was the hardest part of making this movie? What was the most sort of, you know, difficult aspect of your job? Whatever. That's, people are really interested.
Yeah.
And you always kind of like downplay the minor sort of discomforts of like making a movie because it sounds silly. You're like, yeah, we got to have this amazing experience. We were all together like telling this story. Like the fact that it was cold kind of doesn't really matter. This was absolutely horrible, like the worst experience I've ever had on a movie ever.
Finally.
In my entire life.
Finally, and the truth comes
out. And we're like allowed to say it. Like right. Usually you're like, it was great. We loved each other. We liked each other, fine. This was awful, physically harrowing, really scary, claustrophobic, like a genuine experience.
The movie's got a lot of other great people in it, like T.J. Miller. He's only in it for, well, let me just tell you this. One of my favorite T.J. Miller scenes of any movie or television series he's ever been involved with is in this movie, and I can't tell you the moment because it would ruin it, but it is spectacular and unforgettable.
Mamoudou Athie's in it. Jessica Henwick's in it as well. Mamoudou, you're going to be seeing very soon in the new Jurassic World movie if they ever wrap up production on that. And same with Jessica. If she ever wraps up production on the new Matrix, she's in that as well. You also know her from Game of Thrones, of course. But I digress. I talked to him about this. Take a look.
Yeah, intense. I've done some diving and some deep sea diving, and really? I know how claustrophobic this can get. And you guys are in this thing for hours at a time simulating. Yeah. How claustrophobic were you?
Well, Kristen actually had the worst claustrophobia. I wasn't struggling with the claustrophobia.
Just a pinch nerve.
Just, yeah. No, so I weigh like 125, and the suit was 85.
Was
and
it?
So the pain of carrying that, and mine was rigged wrong, and so it was all on one shoulder, and I actually lost feeling in my right shoulder because it trapped my nerves, and I had to sleep in a neck brace for filming.
Goodness gracious. Yeah. How about you? God. Do you have any level of commitment to compare to that?
No, that was fine. I was just like moderately uncomfortable and a little wet. But like,
what was the hardest part?
That sounds
then?
Horrible. Sorry.
What was the most difficult part for you then?
The first couple of days of filming.
Oh, you had it rough.
Oh, yeah, no, the first couple of days of filming, Kristen and I, we were just, like, the water that they were using was cold water.
Sure.
So, you know, would have to lie back into it, and it's like dirty because, you know, it was like a research facility that was got blown up. It just felt uncomfortable, and we were just gross and just wet and cold for like 3 days. And they're like, oh, we can turn up the heat on this. And we're like, oh, could you?
This whole time.
Would you mind?
Mamoudou and Jessica, awesome people, awesome movie. And okay, they're awesome people, but it's not an awesome movie. If we're gonna be real, it's an okay movie. It's good, not great, but I think in the world we live in, having something new makes it a little bit better than it would be otherwise. Don't get me wrong, it doesn't suck. It has some great moments, and when people, as they're off want to do in a movie like this, they do it spectacularly. So in that way, I kind of recommend having fun underwater with your friends and family. All right, speaking of awesome movies, coming to Netflix right now, Sergio. If you haven't watched this movie based on this guy, Sergio, you should. Why? It's director and that guy. Join us next. Welcome to come over and hang out and watch movies. Though the last thing you're gonna wanna do is come over to somebody's house when the pandemic has lifted. All right, speaking of new movies, Netflix has an amazing new movie called Sergio that I highly recommend. The movie's directed by Greg Barker and stars Wagner Moura. If that name sounds familiar, or if he looks kind of familiar to you, you might better know him from Narcos. Yes, he was Pablo Escobar. And it gives me great pleasure to join the both of them right now in their homes. Hey, guys, how are you?
Hi, good. Mark.
They're okay.
How are you adjusting to doing interviews in this way? First and foremost, did you ever in your wildest dreams think we would live in a world where this is the way we were going to promote a movie?
It's actually, it's not been bad. I think it's working well. I've just spoken with a Brazilian journalist and I think it's not bad at all.
I know, Wagner, it might be like by design something you had hoped for your whole life, not to have to really press the flesh with press.
it's working okay.
Greg, congratulations on the film. It's just beautiful. It's epic. It's amazing. It's poignant. It's all the things that it needs to be. What do you say to people? Because I'll tell you what I say. When people say, well, with what the world's going through right now, we need something uplifting and fun. But I say, au contraire, what we need right now is to watch something that reminds us that after this all passes, we still need to fight and celebrate for peace on Earth, right?
What struck me about Sergio is he probably saw more war and human suffering than anybody of his generation. He just was everywhere. Every global hotspot, he was there. Refugee crisis. And a lot of people, when they have those kinds of experiences, become jaded and cynical. Sergio was an optimist. He believed in the human spirit and its ability to persevere. He was an idealist and yet also a pragmatist, and got the world done by inhabiting these kind of shades of gray between good and evil, right and wrong. And he had no time at all for political ideologies that were all about, like, you know, casting blame. So I think, you know, for me, this has always been on one level a story about empathy and about hope and perseverance amidst the darkness. And we're living through dark times. But it's vital that we remember that humanity has gotten through far worse. We will get through, and we need leaders that speak about empathy and hope and not divide us. So for me, I'd never wish this upon us all, but it's actually I hope it's a story that resonates with people right now.
So much that we could learn from him. Wagner, where do you begin? So much pressure to fill these shoes, even theatrically. Where do you begin?
Well, I think it's this is a film that it began when I was, this is part of sort of a more ambitious project that I had, which is to produce films here in the US about Latin people that don't reinforce stereotypes. And I think that Sergio was a very, so it was a great first step. I'm also Brazilian, and I was always very fascinated by him. He's a sort of a personal hero to me. And the way I approach these real life characters that really exist is that I just try to know as much as I can about them to, at some point, forget of everything that I've learned in order to create my own version of the character and to, you know, connect my own feelings and the way I see life with his. Therefore, it's not going to be an imitation, but more like an organic symbiosis between the character and myself. And that's what I did with Sergio. But you're right, there is a lot of responsibility in portraying someone like him.
I'm so glad that the world gets introduced to him. People that might not know the story, I think now this is palatable, something that will introduce him to the rest of the world and also shine some light on the guy he was. Do you ever consider the bookend that you have in terms of roles with Pablo Escobar over here and Sergio over here?
Yeah, they're both exist, and they were both killed in tragic circumstances, and they can and they both can show us a very specific part of history that if we look closer, if we examine both the drug trade and how it began in South America and the role of the UN and the invasion in Iraq, very specific parts of our history that needs to be seen through the eyes of their, you know, people that were in the middle of the hurricane. Two very different persons, of course, but I think it's important to go back in time and see how they, you know, dealt with what was going on.
Amen. Hey guys, thanks for your time. Be well, and congratulations on just masterful work. Appreciate you.
Thank you, Mark.
Thank you.
Take care, man.
Thanks, guys. Yeah, the movie is a remarkable new offering streaming right now, Sergio on Netflix. When we come back, not only are people discovering classic movies, but they're recreating classic movies. Who are these people? How are they doing this? We'll get to know them next. Hey, welcome back to our final segment of Extra Butter. As you shelter in place, I hope you are. I am in my home in Placer County, California. Where do you live? Oh, really? That's one of my favorite places. Hey, I want to talk about one of my favorite movies of all time. As we talk about looking for new stuff for home entertainment, what's old is new, and I've suggested to so many people this movie, The Princess Bride. The reason I bring it up now is because a YouTuber has done something extraordinary, and I introduce you to that YouTuber now. Addison Cash, say hello.
Hi.
Shawn Cash, star of your film, say hello.
Hello.
Okay, for those of you who don't know, what she's done is taken classic scenes from this movie and reproduced them using family and friends during Shelter in Place. Addison, are you an aspiring filmmaker? Because you should be.
Well, I'd like to be, but so me and my cousins used to make like bad lip reading and kid snippets, and that's what gave us the idea to do different scenes from movies.
All right, so rather than talk about it, I want to show you what she does. Take a look.
All right. Where is the poison? The battle of wits has begun. It ends when you decide and we both drink and find out who is right and who is dead.
But it's so simple. All I have to do is divine from what I know of you. Are you the sort of man who would put the poison into his own goblet or his enemies? Now, a clever man would put the poison into his own goblet because he would know that only a great fool would reach for what he was given. I'm not a great fool, so I can clearly not choose the wine in front of you. But you must have known I was not a great fool. You would have counted on it, so I can clearly not choose the wine in front of me. You made your decision then?
And now, so you truly get the genius of that moment, here's a sample of the original. Watch this.
You made your decision then?
Not remotely. Because Iocane comes from Australia, as everyone knows. And Australia is entirely peopled with criminals. And criminals are used to having people not trust them, as you are not trusted by me, so I can clearly not choose the wine in front of you.
Truly, you have a dizzying intellect.
Wait till I get going! Where was I?
Australia.
Yes, Australia. And you must have suspected I would have known the powder's origin, so I can clearly not choose the wine in front of me.
You're just stalling now.
You'd like to think that, wouldn't you?
So, Addison, as someone who loves movies and as a filmmaker, I gotta tell you, I'm blown away. Shot per shot, it's perfection. Dad, can you describe how she did it?
Yeah, she takes her phone and she records the movie, and then she, like a drill sergeant, will take us outside and force the family to reshoot scenes over and over and over until she gets exactly what she's looking for.
So, Addison, how willing are your family and friends to participate in this?
Not very. It is very hard to get them to participate.
Her cousins used to be much more, Megan and Leah had no problem getting involved. Not so much.
You're ready to be a filmmaker because nothing changes, unless there's a budget attached. So, Addison, I noticed you have other movies. How do you pick what movies you do?
So we just take our family favorites and remake them. I mean, it's the movies that we like to rewatch a lot.
Awesome. So Pop, I've known for a long time, a big time radio star. Addison, you are a filmmaking star in the making. And thanks for hanging out with us today.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks, you guys. All right, that's going to wrap it up. I'm going to get back to watching this, and you watch what you will. But for all the interviews with every star of every movie ever, be sure and like and subscribe. It's Extra Butter. We'll see you next time. Be safe, everybody. Be safe. Wash your hands again.